Education Chaplain Amos Durham. Mr. Durham?
Sir, let's all stand, please. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for allowing us to come to the close of another year. Truly have been blessing us and been with us, and we're grateful for that. We ask again, as we've asked the past 11 months, that you be with us during this council meeting. You guide, lead us. All that we say and all that we do benefit those who live in this county and bring glory to your name. We thank you for your presence. Ever with us. We pray this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Roger, if you would listen to the
pledge. Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Chaplain, we appreciate you being with us over here. You're a great asset to our nation. We have presentation out of a re-presentation of the 2017 Park Excellent Award for Holmes and Creek. And this is by Jim Hedrick, Executive Director of South Carolina Recs and Parks and Recs, and Kevin Stein's to receive it today. How are you today? Good to have you.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman and County Council members and citizens of Spartanburg. It is indeed an honor to be here again. My name is Jim Hedley. I'm with the South Carolina Recreation Parks Association, and we represent all the local public park and recreation agencies throughout the state of South Carolina. There are approximately 1,100 members with 100 public park and recreation agencies as our membership. As you mentioned, this is a representing an award that Spartanburg County won. And we originally were going to be here in September, but there's a little storm off the coast of South Carolina that was threatening our state, and we had to kind of reschedule our conference and ended up having it last week. So we appreciate the opportunity to be here again, and certainly would like to thank the council and staff for having us up here. Our association's vision statement is creating community through people, parks, and programs. And as each of you know, it takes a very progressive and forward-thinking council in order for these folks to be able to do their job. And with that, when you give them the support that they have, you start to see how a community will come together. And they'll come together to have either a place for themselves to go recreate or recreate, place for their families, as well as places for economic impact to come in, such as places like Tiger River. And so a good public parks and recreation department will be a reflection of its community. And this department, amongst many others across the state, does just that. And with that, the Spartanburg County Parks and Recreation Department received our Parks Excellence Award for Holston Creek. We are pleased that Holston Creek Park, as a recipient of the 2017 SCRPA Parks Excellence Award, celebrating the achievement of the agency's mission through construction of a park and positive impact that it has had on its community. The Spartanburg County Parks Department references a simple tagline as a way to communicate the role it serves the community, your partner in community wellness. Tagline is exemplified in the wellness opportunities available at Holston Creek Park. The opportunity provides this park opportunity provides opportunity for those who wish to participate in passive recreation, as well as those who wish to engage in more strenuous activity. Holston Creek provides a unique recreation opportunities such as fishing, walking, disc golf, geocaching, mountain biking, or bird watching. But it also offers opportunities for traditional recreation such as athletic youth leagues, picnic shelters, walking trails, and playgrounds. In addition, Holston Creek Park has a rich agricultural history and was formerly used as a working peach farm. This history is reflected in the park as design builds on natural landscape, minimizing impact on existing natural resources, and reflecting the history of the former peach farm. The balance of the diverse recreational opportunities, maximizing landforms and natural resources, and creating impactful partnerships were all part of the success of Holston Creek Park. Parks and recreation agencies are vitally important to establishing and maintaining a quality of life in its community, ensuring the health, wellness of its citizens, and contributing to the economic and environmental well-being of a community. By developing this new facility, the Spartanburg County Parks Department has achieved this by providing access to a unique park that is now an asset to the community. So with this, I'd like to present to Kevin and Council the 2017 Parks Excellence Award for population over 30,000 to Spartanburg County, Holston Creek Park.
Chairman, before they leave, that's in the best district, Spartanburg County, and that's one of the best parks out there. We hear all about the
county. Okay, Mr. Walker. Item B, recognition of county participation in the 2017 Healthy Communities 50 Challenge. Sherry Barrett, Emily O'Sullivan, members of the Healthy Community Task Force here to present. And I think you want me to come down? Is that what I heard? Okay.
Good evening. My name is Emily O'Sullivan, and I'm with the South Carolina Hospital Association. And I'm joined by my colleague, Sherry Barrett, with Upstate Forever. We both serve on the Healthy Community 50 Steering Committee. And we are here today to thank you so much for Spartanburg County's participation in the Healthy Community 50 Challenge. And we would like to present you with a token of our appreciation. But before we do, I just wanted to give a little bit of background on the challenge in case some of you may not be aware, and some of our residents and attendants here may not be aware. But the Healthy Community 50 Challenge is a national challenge sponsored by the Aetna Foundation, the American Public Health Association, and the National Association of Municipalities. It is a two-year challenge, and Spartanburg County was selected as one of 50 communities across the country to participate in this challenge. At the end of the 2 years, they will select a winner that will win a grand prize of $500,000. So we definitely have our sights set on that. And then there's four runner-up prizes of $25,000. Our specific challenge in Spartanburg County was to focus on increasing physical activity among our residents. So we did that in three primary ways. The first was to organize community walks with elected officials in the six municipalities in Spartanburg County that are participating, as well as the county itself. And so this served as an opportunity for residents to get out and about and get moving, but also as a way to connect with their elected officials on issues that are important to them. So I want to say a special thank you to all the councilmen that participated in those walks: Justin Bradley, David Britt, and Whitney Farr. And did I miss anyone? Mr. Walker, thank you. Thank you so much for your participation and your support and your leadership. The second component was a physical activity challenge among the municipal and county employees. And so we did that through an online platform where employees were encouraged to track their daily steps and minutes of physical activity. And then they competed for a trophy that rotated around the county, as well as other prizes. So I also want to thank the councilmen that participated in that challenge: Justin Bradley, David Britt, and Michael Brown. Thank you so much. The last component is participation in working well. So four out of those seven entities that I mentioned participated in working well, which is actually the initiative that I work for through the Hospital Association. And it is a statewide strategy where we work with employers to help them implement best practices in employee well-being to create cultures of wellness within their organization. And so I want to thank Spartanburg County specifically for their participation in that, for making employee health a priority. And when we work with employers, when they achieve what we define as the highest standard of excellence in one of nine dimensions of well-being that we focus on, we recognize them as one of our platinum recipients. And I just want to say that Spartanburg County is very close to achieving platinum in a couple of those nine dimensions of well-being. So just want to say congratulations and also just encourage the county to continue pursuing employee health. Also want to say a special thank you to Jim Hipp and Kevin Steins with the county for serving on the Healthy Community 50 Steering Committee as well. They were both instrumental in helping us to plan and execute all of these activities. So as we wrap up year one, we're looking at ways to improve and reach more people throughout the county. And so again, we want to thank you all who participated in 2017 and invite you all to join us again in 2018. As soon as we have the dates for the next quarterly walks this coming year, we will let you know and hope that you can join us. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Sherry, and she's going to present you with a certificate of recognition.
Chairman Horton, you'd like to
perform. Justin, why don't you do it? You participated in both of them. You're vice chair. Let Justin do it.
The Healthy Community 50 Spartanburg County, South Carolina Certificate of Recognition for Spartanburg County. And it says, in recognition for your 2017 participation in the National Healthy Community 50 Challenge as part of Spartanburg County's efforts to improve community health through greater physical activity. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next, we have employee recognition, Catherine O'Neill.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman and members of council. Before I start, I just want to give my own congratulations to Kevin, to you and to your team, winning the 2017 Parks Excellence Award for Holston Creek. I know that that was something that was very important to you, and congratulations. You guys worked very hard for that, so thank you for representing us so well. Next, I'd like to recognize Amanda Cockrell and Pam Ferguson with communications. Are they both here? No, right, they're not here. Okay, so we're going to wait till January then for their recognition. So they received the Palmetto Award, so I'd like to have them come back then in January if we can to recognize them. That is a significant recognition. Next, I'd like to call on several employees from the Environmental Enforcement Department. I think, Jamie, you have your team here. So we have Michelle Ferris, Christy Snow, John Grooms, and David Jorgensen. Have you guys seen that? So you may know about this, but I want to be sure that you hear a little bit more about it. We had a citizen who wrote in to express her gratitude for the work that these officers did in her community. This team utilized our trap and release program to help us kind of gain control of an area that was overrun with feral cats, and they were significant. They had a significant impact on that, and just want to thank you for all your time and effort with that. So, Council, will you help me thank them for their all the work that they did in this community? And lastly, Council, I received a letter from Robert Kroon with SCAC that I'd like to share with you. Robert had reached out to both Jenny and to me to thank her for being part of a program here recently. I think it was when it was snowing here. But I just want to read the letter to you. It says, thank you ever so much for being one of the stars on the faculty for the 2007 Local Government Attorneys Institute. This is a program we put together as a service not only to the county attorneys, but many other attorneys in the state and local government. The program would not be possible without the participation of great faculty members like yourself. He goes on to talk about some of the ratings, particularly that Jenny received, and he ended with, "I do not exaggerate when I say that your participation was a key to one of the most well-received programs for this event that we have hosted in 20-some-odd years. Kent has made numerous comments about how helpful your perspective has been in both this presentation and in the Freedom of Information Act handbook work." So, Jenny, thank you for representing us so well in this particular workshop. I know it was very helpful to the attorneys that attended. That's all I had.
Thank you.
If you'll join me in thanking Jenny.
Thank you, Catherine.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
One thing before we go ahead, I would like to say that Saturday we had the opportunity to have the Shriners have their Shrine Bowl here. It was a fantastic day. The only problem was North Carolina beat up on us pretty good, but we had an excellent attendance that day. And I applaud the Shriners and all they do to promote, and we're fortunate to have them here this time of year, every year. And these young men that are representing us in North Carolina, they're bigger than Michael a lot of times. So we got some outstanding young people. So it was my honor to be there and participate with it. So.
Thanks for the comment, Bob. The next item, the company has called and requested postponing the public hearing until January 22nd. Earlier today, we had our committee reports, first committees, economic recruitment and development. Honorable David Britt, Chairman. Mr. Britt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. After I got chastised by Councilman Walker, I'm going to slow it down a little bit today. See, we went faster in the committee meetings. I'm not going to slow down much.
Yeah.
First item that we had before the committee, we recommend to full council that we adopt a resolution authorizing the amendment of a lease agreement between Spartanburg County, South Carolina, and Hinkle Corporation. I move that we adopt this resolution, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative, and it passes.
The next item came before the committee. We have a request to render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County, South Carolina, and Project Bobsled 1. I move that we render first reading.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item 2. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative, and it passes.
The next item also relates to Project Bobsled, but we have a request to render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County, South Carolina, and Project Bobsled 2. I move that we render first reading.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Next item, the committee recommends that we render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg, South Carolina, and Project Bobsled 3. I move that we render first reading.
Second.
Have a motion and a second on item 4. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Next item, the committee recommends, and I move that we adopt a resolution authorizing under certain conditions the execution and delivery by Spartanburg County, South Carolina, of a fee in lieu tax agreement with a company known to the county as Project Addition.
So
we have a motion and a second on item 5. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative, and it passes.
Next item, committee recommends, and I move that we render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County, South Carolina, and a company known to the county as Project Addition.
Okay.
We have a motion and a second on item 6. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Next item, committee recommends, and I move that we render first readings and ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of an agreement governing the multi-county park, Broad River Energy, LLC, authorizing the inclusion of certain property located in Cherokee County in the multi-county park.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item 7. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Next item, committee recommends, and I move that we render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of an agreement governing the multi-county park, Cherokee County Cogeneration, authorizing the inclusion of certain property located in Cherokee County in the multi-county park.
Second.
Have a motion and a second on item 8. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative and it passes.
Next item, the committee recommends, and I move that we render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of an agreement governing the multi-county park, Core Molding Technologies, authorizing the inclusion of certain property located in Cherokee County in the multi-county park.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item 9. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
And the last item, the committee recommends, and I move that we render first reading authorizing the execution and delivery of an agreement governing the multi-county park, Gaffney Meadow Creek ADS Logistics, authorizing the inclusion of certain property located in Cherokee County in this multi-county park.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item 10. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
Mr. Chairman, that concludes our committee report.
Thank you, Mr. Britt.
Yes, sir.
No items under B, public health. Next, we have personnel and finance. Honorable Bob Walker, Chairman. Mr. Walker.
Mr. Chairman, we had three items for action earlier tonight. And number one is we received information and took desired action in reference to a resolution certifying one unit as an abandoned building site located, as per the state law, as and located at 2150 East Main Street in Duncan. And Mr. Chairman, I move we approve this resolution.
We have a motion on item 1. Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative.
Special assessment period, as per state law, for the real property known as Arcadia Mills. And Mr. Chairman, I move to adopt this resolution.
All right. We have a motion on 2.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
We also received information, took desired action in reference to an ordinance to provide certification of a site requested by Cleveland Street LLC as per state law for 1875 Haines Street in Spartanburg. Mr. Chairman, I move for adoption of this ordinance, further reading of this ordinance.
All right, we have a motion and a second by Mr. Brown. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? The vote affirmative, and it passes.
We also received earlier during our committee meeting the information on our annual financial audit from the McGee Swartz Holiday Company, and that was for information. We also received other reports of action. That concludes our action at our earlier committee meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Mark. We have livability. Honorable Justin Bradley, Chairman. Mr. Bradley.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We had one item come before our committee today, and that was a request from the Blue Ways Coalition for some funding for river access along the Tiger River. And they moves that we authorize funding through our parks funds.
All right, we have a motion on item 1.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes. That concludes livability. Next, we have public safety and judiciary. Honorable Michael Brown, Chairman. Mr. Brown.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We had one item that principally came before the committee. We heard from our county director, Mr. Doug Bryson, in terms of activities that are associated with Spartanburg County multi-jurisdictional hazard mitigation plan. And the committee recommends, and I move that we adopt that resolution.
Second.
All right, we have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
That's all the matters that came before our committee.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Item F, no items under land use tonight. No items under public works. So now we'll go to public comment period, and again, it's 3 minutes each. First person is Ruth Littlejohn, 284 Marion Avenue. Is Ms. Littlejohn here tonight? Hey, how are you? You have 3 minutes, Ms. Littlejohn. Mr. Jim Hip will be keeping time for us. Thank you for being here.
Good evening, Mr. Chair, Gushing Council members. My name, as you have said, is Jessie Ruth Lum John, Gushing, I live at 284 Marion Avenue. On November the 24th of this year, I was overcome with joy. I read in the paper that you, Jeff Barton, has reached a point of frustration with litter in Spartanburg County and plan on taking action but through greater efforts, especially in litter control and enforcement. And the trash in Spartanburg County has been a deep concern of mine since I moved here. As my husband and I got moved around for 21 years, we traveled, I don't know why I'm feeling nervous before you all, but when I'm going to be sitting on there, I hope soon. My husband and I got moved around after 21 years, and we traveled in the Air Force. I've never seen as much trash, in other counties as I do here, in Spartanburg County. I have not seen, the litter signs got posted any place in our county, and if there is such signage, it's being ignored because an enforcement does not seem to be a priority. I am always ashamed because to have friends that travel along Highway 221 in the upright along 221 got starting at South Church Street, North Point, the 221 is always a trashy mess. I've already spoken with Councilman Brown, in hopes that we can work together to make this area more attractive for visitors who are traveling along this route and to residents who have grown tired of seeing this mess. I work tirelessly in my community, picking up trash daily, trying to help my community and our city be a clean and safe place to live. I plan on running for City Council in District 3, in a special election in 2018. One of my platform messages is making Spartanburg a cleaner place to live. I will work with County Council and City Council members to help reach this goal. We have so much development here in Spartanburg County. I feel it's important that we do our part to bring the sparkle out in this jewel that we call home. I want to thank you once again, Chairman Horton, for taking steps to literally clean up Spartanburg County. And I do apologize for being nervous.
That's fine, Ms. Littlejohn. You're a recent graduate of the Citizens Committee, so you know you shouldn't be nervous, but thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Next, we have Bill Coker.
Mr. Chairman, members of council, thank you for the opportunity to speak with you all tonight. As you said, I'm Bill Coker. I'm with South State Bank here in Spartanburg, and I'm here tonight in my capacity as a trustee of the Mary Black Foundation. To refresh your memory, the foundation is a private grant-making foundation that invests in the people, the communities of Spartanburg County for improved health, wellness, and success. We have two primary areas of focus. One is early childhood development. The other is healthy eating and active living. And it is the healthy eating and active living component of our work that I wanted to speak to you more specifically about tonight. I've been on the board since 2008, and in my time on the board, I've learned a great deal about what it takes to create a healthy and vibrant community. I've had an opportunity to participate in decisions that the foundation has made on joint efforts with the county to fund projects such as the Cleveland Park Playground, Berry Field, many, many other walking trails and parks throughout the county. I'd like to commend your staff, many of whom I think were recognized earlier in the meeting. They have been excellent partners to our staff at the foundation. We observed that they worked very hard to maintain the county's parks and trails and community centers. They create and implement programs that promote community wellness. And they collaborate with us and other organizations to encourage our citizens to use and enjoy the county's resources. It's important that the county continue to invest in quality of life infrastructure. You all know this. We have a growing body of research that shows that walking and biking infrastructure fosters the development of new activity-related businesses. It raises property values. It encourages private investment. It promotes tourism, and it reduces injuries and other work-related care, healthcare costs. I've been a resident of Spartanburg County for 35 years and a banker that entire amount of time. At no time in those 35 years have I been more excited about the development and the positive momentum that I see for our county right now. We all want our business community to grow. That's how we improve economic opportunity for everyone. We want South State Bank to grow too, but to do that, it takes a strong, qualified workforce. That workforce is not going to be from my generation or your generation. We need the younger generations to really live and work in Spartanburg County. You all have seen this document that the Chamber put together, the Community and Economic Development Strategy. There's an entire section of this document that is devoted to quality of place. It's clear that that plays a significant role in our ability to attract and retain the talent that we need to help grow our businesses. I'll quote from this document very briefly. The Spartanburg community is fortunate to have an existing greenways and trails master plan advanced by a broad coalition led by the Partners for Active Living. The community should pursue an aggressive timeline for implementation of the plan, primarily through the commitment additional public resources. I know that you all are faced with very difficult funding decisions each year. I commend you for the decision that you made tonight regarding the Spartanburg County Greenways. But I want you to know that many community leaders, including me, support funding for trails and parks and other quality of life efforts because we see these amenities as a vital tool for economic development and for workforce attraction. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. Next we have Kimberly McKinney. Is Kimberly here?
Good evening.
Good evening.
And again, my name is Kimberly McKinney, and I'm speaking on behalf of the clerk of court's office at the courthouse concerning the mold. My main concern is our health, and I can speak on everyone at the clerk of court's office that that is our number one priority. The chemicals that they are using to try to get rid of the mold is also a problem. I mean, just as an example today, the chemicals with the air circulating was terrible. It's causing our eyes to burn, we're having chest pains, it's just not acceptable. Every day we step into that building is affecting our lives, and it seems like no one seems to care. No one in that courthouse is safe as long as the mold continues to grow. We have people in the courthouse that's been there for less than a year that now have no sick time or vacation because they have been out sick with bronchitis or other sinus infections that is coming from the mold. I personally have eye problems, I have sinus problems, nosebleed, and all this maybe not coming exactly, well, if I already have sinus problems, the mold is not helping at all, and neither is the chemicals that they are using. I feel like no one seems to really pay attention to what we are saying, that our health is important to us. We love working for Spartanburg County. I've been there 15 years. I love my job, but I do not like working in an environment that's going to endanger my health every day. I feel like every day that I step in that courthouse, that my life is numbered. And all we are asking is, put us in a safe environment. It's going to take 4 years to build this new courthouse. We may not have 4 years. So all we are asking is, put us in a safe environment so that we can do the job that you all and our community will want us to do. Thank you.
Thank you, Kimberly. Next we have Clerk of Court, Hope Blackley.
Good evening.
Evening.
I want to thank you all for having me tonight, and also like to thank you all with the help of the passage of the city sales tax with the hopes of getting a new facility in the next 4 years. But I'm also here to take the opportunity to make each of council members aware of the events that took place today at the courthouse. Local staff members, including the assigned family court judge, Shane Fraley, became ill. Possible reaction to the chemicals being used from this past weekend remediation. This isn't a recent problem, but as most of you are aware by the emails I've sent you, from ongoing problems from my courthouse staff. Some staff members left today or were removed from having dizziness, vomiting, headaches, and faintness. To have some lessen these staff members' reaction is very disheartening and disingenuous. Unless you can come and work in this environment daily, I would think it would be hard for me or anyone else to pass judgment of them. The bigger concern, especially from some of our judicial staff, who have great concern about holding court in a courthouse, is the multiple remediations in the same area, three times or possibly more. Concerns conducting air quality tests and making those findings public weeks or even months later, such as with the OSHA report last year, doesn't calm fears or reduce concerns. It only heightens when areas have been contained immediately and incite bigger concerns for other areas of contamination. The question that's repeatedly asked, why are we left to work in such conditions and how do we know that this area or that area is safe, when the last test rendered it fine, but the next testing is not fine? I'm doing all I can to continue to calm fears and to attend to those who have been affected with concern and understanding. I would encourage all involved to be proactive and not reactive, which has been the case with the situation we've been dealing with. It has been said that the situation is better now versus in the past, and I beg to differ on that thought. Please know that the invitation for each of you to come to the courthouse to witness and experience the issues firsthand is an open door policy and will always be an open door policy. However, we must find a reasonable solution to the current problems until we complete the building of the new courthouse, even if that means relocation off-site elsewhere in the city or county. I'd like to thank Councilman Justin Bradley, Whitney Farr, and Michael Brown for their responses and their visit today to see and experience the concerns, and Councilman Farr's visits on a weekly basis. Morale is very low, and I believe the patience of the courthouse staff is wearing off. I respectfully ask and need your support. This is a health concern and a safety concern. I beg for your support. Staff and all for those who enter the courthouse while we wait for the completed construction of the new facility and the quality of life and their working environment. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Becker. Thank you very much. That concludes public comment period. Next, we have old business. Render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of the First Amendment to a fee in lieu tax incentive.
So moved.
Second. We have a motion and a second on item A. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative and it passes. Item B, render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of an amended and restated fee in lieu agreement by and between Spartanburg, South Carolina and Bentler Automotive.
So moved.
Second. We have a motion and a second on item B. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative and it passes. Item C, render third reading to an ordinance to amend the agreement for development for joint county industrial park by between Spartanburg and Cherokee County, so as to include additional property in Spartanburg County as part of the joint park for Palmetto Hospitality of Spartanburg.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second on item C. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item D, render third reading to an ordinance to amend the agreement for development of joint county industrial park by and between Spartanburg County and Cherokee County, so as to include additional property located in Spartanburg County as part of the joint industrial park related to AWL.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item D. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item E, render third reading to an ordinance designated and approving Ernie's Pride LLC as a sponsor affiliate in satisfaction of the requirements of Title 12, Chapter 24 Dakota Laws for fee and rue between South Carolina and Magna Seating.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second on item E. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item F, render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a special source credit agreement by and between Spartanburg, South Carolina, BMW Manufacturing.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item F. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item 6 was requested to be postponed until January 22nd.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we carry that over to January.
Okay.
Second.
A motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Thank you much. Item H, render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee and lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg, South Carolina and Carbon Conversions.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item H. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative, and it passes. No items under new business, miscellaneous matters. Council will have a little get-together immediately following the meeting. Budget, item B, budget amendment resolutions. We have a motion on the BARs.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. I need approval of the minutes of November 13, November 17 retreat, November 17 public works committee, and November 20 regular meeting.
So moved.
Have a motion.
Second.
Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Merry Christmas, safe and happy new year. We are adjourned.